Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to another episode of Did You Know, where you literally know what you need to know. Alhamdulillah, today we are privileged to have Dr. Muhammad Salah from Egypt. But before you get to know what you need to know, stay tuned and we will be right back. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, Shaykh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Welcome to Did You Know.
How are you, Brother Shorim?
Alhamdulillah, Shaykh.
Good to see you.
It's beautiful to have you here.
Thank you for hosting me.
How is Egypt?
Wonderful, alhamdulillah.
MashaAllah, you've been the one hosting people on Huda TV. Today I'm hosting you on my show.
Alhamdulillah, it's a pleasure.
Jazakallah khair. So, Shaykh, today I want to talk about, you know, in our recent times today, zina has become so easy for people to do, and the marriage has been made so hard. What do you think is the problem?
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, praise be to Allah alone, we all praise Him and we seek His help. Whomsoever Allah guides is the truly guided one, and whomsoever Allah leaves astray, none can show Him guidance. The answer lies in Surah Taha. And the story begins since Allah the Almighty sent down Adam and Eve to earth. So they both repented after they committed the sin and they were exposed. So they repented to Allah the Almighty. Allah the Almighty said, فَإِمَّا يَأْتِيَنَّكُمْ مِنِّي هُدًى فَمَنِ اتَّبَعَ هُدَايَ فَلَا يَضِلُّ وَلَا يَشْقَى وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ. Which means that he accepted the tawbah of Adam and Eve. Then he said, I'm going to give you hidayah, guidance. Whosoever follows my guidance, فَمَنِ اتَّبَعَ هُدَايَ فَلَا يَضِلُّ وَلَا يَشْقَى. He shall never go astray, no shall suffer of any distress. So there is a big link and a very strong tie and a relationship between following the divine guidance and having comfort, peace of mind, and not suffering of any distress, depression, or those diseases which may end up with committing suicide and taking people's life. You follow His guidance, you're peaceful.
Yes, serenity.
You're experiencing comfort, serenity, and tranquility. وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ. As for those who turn away from my reminder, Allah promises, لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ. The life will be miserable.
SubhanAllah.
Will be full of trouble, full of afflictions, because you slipped off the straight path. You turn away from His guidance. He didn't follow the manual. وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى. Not only the suffering in this life is the only punishment. No. The severest consequences will be in the hereafter. May Allah protect us against that. Whenever people close one of the doors of goodness, many doors to evil will be opened up. Not just one.
Many.
Whenever people neglect a sunnah, that opens doors to bid'ah and innovations. Whenever people tighten an opening or a window to what is halal and lawful, it opens a lot of doors to the haram. I mean by that, when Allah the Almighty ordered us to facilitate and to make easy and affordable marriage, even in poor conditions and under poverty. In ayah number 32 of Surah An-Nur, the light surah, Allah the Almighty says, وَأَنْكِحُوا الْأَيَامَ مِنْكُمْ وَالصَّالِحِينَ مِنْ عِبَادِكُمْ وَإِمَائِكُمْ إِنْ يَكُونُوا فُقَرَاءَ يُغْنِهِمُ اللَّهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ وَاللَّهُ وَاسِعٌ عَلِيمٌ. Many people will say, I can't get married. Why can't you? It is so expensive. I agree. We made it complicated.